Good day, everyone. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
As we do come together to celebrate the joy of the resurrection, let us continue to pray with Pope Francis for peace in our world and for unity in the Church. And we also remember in a special way during our Mass today the souls of Maureen Cusumano and Jimmy Verga. And so let us unite our hearts and minds as we do begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, to celebrate truly with joy this Easter Sunday, let us again ask the Lord for his mercy and his forgiveness. Rise up in the light of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first. And he saw and believed. But they did not yet understand the scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And now.
Amen.
end. You are my one true friend. Isn't that so true this morning? As we celebrate Easter Sunday, the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, our friend Jesus. He is the true friend. He is the true Lamb of God. He is the true Savior of the world. He is that true friend who, even after being betrayed by Judas, by Peter, having been left abandoned by his closest friends, he is that true friend, even though he suffered at the hands of sinners, suffered under our hands because of our unfaithfulness, because of our disloyalty, because we offended him by our lack of charity and compassion in our lives. He is that true friend who willingly gave his life on the cross. He is that true friend whom we celebrate today, rising from the dead. And as that true and faithful friend, Jesus now has opened the gates of eternal life, our true home, to each and every one of us. He always remains faithful, even if we do not. He is that true friend who shows us what love is, how we are called, like him, to die to self so that others may live. He is the true friend who shows us that the seed has to die in order to bear fruit. He is the true friend who will always be there, waiting for us to return, to be surprised by life, surprised by his love and mercy. In the end, Jesus is our true friend. Jesus is risen from the dead. Let us always rejoice and be glad. Alleluia. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Christ is the Lord of life, raised up by the Father. In his turn, he will raise us up by his power. Lord Jesus, light shining in the darkness, you lead your people into life and give our mortal nature the gift of holiness. May we spend this day in praise of your glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you walk the way of suffering and crucifixion. May we suffer and die with you and rise again to share your glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Son of the Father, our Master and our true friend, you have made us a kingdom of priests for our God. May we offer you our joyful sacrifice of praise. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
King of glory, we look forward to the great day of your coming in splendor, that we may see you face to face and be transformed in your likeness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and let us celebrate with our Blessed Mother Mary as we pray together. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And we make our prayer through Christ our Lord. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
The bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, the clergy, the religious, and all of your people. Remember your servants Maureen Cusimano and Jimmy Virgo, and also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Our Lady of Good Voyage, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Peter, Saint Anne, and Saint Joachim, St. Francis and St. Clare, St. Anthony, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Peace I give you.
Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Yeah.